Stonebwoy from Ghana or X from Ghana. And like, you see the fans sometimes turning their back. They come to Ghana and then we help them. But I want to also blame part of our radio presenters and our media people. As media people, I think we seem to hail foreigners or outsiders so much than giving that attention to our own people. Do you feel hurt?
Thank you very much, boss. I think I'm describing more than hurt that type of situation, how it looks like. But my hurt is actually coming from, I think, our part. Exactly, because we can only sort of fix ourselves to be able to be happier compared to any other receiving end. So I'll take it from the Nigerian part. I don't have a problem with it. I honestly cannot blame anybody out there in Nigeria for whatever they do to us. Like how it's being seen and it's being speculated. Because one, you can't force anybody to, you know, accept what they do not know or whatever. But to be very, very, very honest, the last 2-3 months have seen me going into Nigeria to do some shows back to back, like Sound City MVP, which is one of the biggest. I was among the top 2-3 to close the show. Afrima was on top 3 to close the show, mostly in Nigeria. On the continent of Africa, I think I should be honest with you, and Nigeria loves me.
It's true.
So I will never actually paint them black in this situation because I'll take time to die in now so we all get the picture clear. When I step up Nigeria, I want a lap from one. Yes, well, from immigration to wherever I go. But I think that is not it all. On stages I've played, if I think that they're rubbish to me as one of the boys on the continent, I would be like a stage opener, the treatment and hospitality would be rough. But honestly speaking, I'm one of the person who would like to hide things that have to be told to fix the problem. If the problem hasn't been fixed yet already. Nigeria gives me my respect. Whatever it be on my technical rider or my performance rider, it's obeyed. And I go in and do that as a performer. Whatever business that they need, the most also. But when it comes to the fan base, I think that their industry has a certain regulation that doesn't allow inflow like that. So on one-on-one basis, you may be previewed or privileged or open to enjoying other people's music from across Africa and the world. But everybody literally gets the same treatment. I've seen other top artists from outside of Africa get the same treatment. And one of the things I can say now, not having talked about, is that I think there's a lot more to do in penetrating.